أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, we talked about the American philosopher Mortimer Adler, who was the chief editor of Encyclopedia Britannica. And he had hundreds of books written, including Synopticon and the Western Ideas. And we mentioned in the book, which I ruined by the rubber band, Six Great Ideas, that the West is based on these ideas. Three of them: truth, goodness, and beauty. These three ideas are ideas we judge by, and liberty, equality, and justice, ideas we act on. And he said that truth presides over goodness and beauty, and justice presides over liberty and equality. So to summarize, the foundation and the basics of the Western civilization, they are built on truth and justice. And I mentioned previously that Islam is based on truth and justice. In the Quran, we read, وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا. And these concepts are very well known. I mentioned several stories where the answer would come to be honest, truthful, and to apply justice and fairness in all aspects of life, from the individual all the way to states. However, today I'm going to bring the statistics of these issues. In the Quran, we have axial definitions or words which give us the reflection and give us idea about what is important. For example, the word Allah, God, is mentioned in the Quran thousands of times, and to add to it the attributes and the names of Almighty God, Al-Asma Al-Husna, they come to several thousands. And of the words which are very axial and important in the Quran is the word truth, Al-Haqq. It's mentioned in the Quran 227 times. And there's derivatives, they add to it tens of words. Part of al-haq, the truth, is as-sidq, which is acting upon the truth, to tell the truth and to act upon the truth. As-sidq, telling the truth, and honesty, is mentioned in the Quran 153 times. And there are additional tens of occasions the derivatives of this word has been mentioned. How about the word al-adl, justice? Is mentioned in the Quran in over 70 times with the words adl and qist, and mentioning the opposite of justice, which is the transgression and oppression and all these acts which are quite the opposite of the word justice, like al-zulm, al-baghi, al-tughyan, to tell us how it is important in the Quran and the Islamic teaching to avoid those deviations, al-zulm, the transgression and injustice, and to apply justice in all aspects of our lives as individuals, as family, as society, as even countries and states. So we should remember this, that this is very important in Islam, to be truthful, honest, and to be fair and just, because this is also the foundation, beside being the foundation of the Western civilization, it's the foundation of the Islamic faith, truth and justice. How about the other moral values who are competing together? We have the word al-khayr, goodness, which is of those ideas. Goodness is mentioned in the Quran, and the Arabic word for it is al-khayr. Al-khayr is mentioned 180 times, and there is additional derivatives of this word in tens of times. So it is also one of the goals of the faith, is competing in doing good and acting in a good manner. And this is also at the level of individuals, families, parents and children, relative, extended family, society, and countries. The mission of Islam is doing good and propagate good. استبقوا الخيرات, compete in doing good. I mentioned to you one time when we talked about democracy in America, about Alexis de Tocqueville, when a journalist summarized the book, 700-800 pages, with one word in 1941. He said, the summary of this book is, America is great because it is good. And whenever it ceases to be good, it will cease to be great. So this is a lesson to all of us. If we want to be somebody, to be great, we need to pursue goodness and believe in goodness and act on goodness towards ourselves, family, society, and countries, and all humanity. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.